You've seen the ginormous racks people have in data centers and even in their homes. Massive, over the top, packed with servers, networking gear, and blinking lights. But there's something smaller that's gaining popularity, the 10-inch mini rack. You guys, this is it. Yep, all that power, all those ports, all those capabilities in this tiny little rack. So why did I build these? I've already built a compute-focused mini rack before that really showed off what's possible with a mini rack. But after Jeff Geerling had me on his video talking about mini home labs, I started thinking, there are so many people who don't have a server in their basement. Yeah, those people exist. But almost every household has some kind of router or access point and connects to the internet. That got me thinking, what if I built a mini rack just for networking? And not just one, but two. A 4U mini rack that's compact, powerful, and more capable than what 99% of homes have right now, and an 8U mini rack with even more. More connectivity, more PoE, more bandwidth, and even 10 gigabit networking. And the best part is, you can put almost anything you want inside of them. These mini racks pack a serious punch in a compact form factor. Whether you're looking to upgrade your home network or build a dedicated networking home lab, they offer a ton of flexibility. Now, I'll walk you through what's inside and why a network-focused mini rack might make sense and how you might not need a massive setup to get a reliable, well-organized network at home. I'll also talk about some of the changes I would love to see from these 10-inch mini racks from DeskPi. Oh, and if you're wondering what those funny-looking colored chips are, don't worry, I'll explain that too. Just to be clear, DeskPi sent me these racks and one even arrived as a Christmas gift with no expectations. At first, I thought it was too small to be useful, but as you'll see, I was completely wrong about that. Also, I wanted to mention that some of these network devices were sent to me by Ubiquiti for testing, while others I purchased myself. Neither DeskPi nor Ubiquiti have any input into this video. So let's get started. This is the 4U mini rack from DeskPi, designed to be filled with anything you can imagine. Now, 4U means 4 rack units tall, where 1U is about 1¾ inches. It's 10 inches wide compared to the 19-inch server racks that you'll see in data centers, or otherwise known as my basement. If you noticed, many of the mounts and brackets here are 3D printed, making this setup even more customizable if you have access to a printer. At the top, we have the Cloud Gateway Ultra, which is really the brains of this network. It acts as the router and firewall and hosts the UniFi network controller where you can manage your network and other UniFi devices. It's USB-C powered and has one 2.5 gigabit WAN port for your internet connection and 4 1 gigabit LAN ports to connect to other devices on your network. Keeping things clean, I 3D printed a custom mount that includes keystone jacks for easy cable management. Below that, we have a 7-port PoE switch, and all 7 are 1 gigabit ports and all 7 support PoE or power over Ethernet. That can help provide network and power for devices like wireless access points, IoT devices, Raspberry Pis, security cameras, most USB devices with the right adapter, and even other switches like the ones I've added below. Now, even if you're only powering a single access point, I think that a PoE switch like this makes a lot more sense than using a standalone PoE injector. You get a lot more flexibility, extra ports, and room to expand if you ever need it. What makes this switch even more interesting is that it can be powered by PoE while still supplying PoE to other devices that are connected to it. And yes, we're going to try that out later. And below that is a pair of Flex Mini switches that are compact and expand your network by adding 4 additional ports each. They can be powered by USB-C or PoE as these are now. You don't have to keep them in the rack, just place them anywhere in your home, connect an Ethernet cable, and boom, more ports instantly without plugging in power adapters. No network would be complete without Wi-Fi, so I've added this Wi-Fi 7 access point and it's powered by PoE, of course. This one specifically supports Wi-Fi 7 and 6 GHz for ultra-fast speeds, and it can handle up to 300 clients, way more than your typical home has. And again, since it's PoE, you can mount it anywhere an Ethernet cable can reach for the best coverage. And if you need more range, just add another access point and plug it into the switch. So now on to the 8U mini rack that I used previously for a mini home lab. With twice the space and a different gateway, this setup brings in even more networking, more PoE, and a wider variety of devices to connect. For this build, I went with the Cloud Gateway Max, which is a step up from the Ultra. It has 5 2.5 gigabit network ports, 1 WAN and 4 LAN, which is a pretty big step up from the Ultra. It also runs multiple UniFi applications, Access, Talk, and even UniFi Protect, which can record your video footage locally onto the built-in NVMe storage. Just install Protect, connect a couple of cameras, and you have a camera security MVR. On the right and left, you can see I've added the same ports for the LAN and WAN connection to connect to the gateway. Oh, and if you're wondering about these color labels, they're a cool printable design that's meant to cover blinking switch lights. But instead of blocking them completely, I printed them in a clear filament so that the lights are still visible, then I added custom labels on the top. I color-coded them for LAN, WAN, PoE, and even my access point, kind of like a DIY version of Ether lighting, since these switches don't have it. But really, you can customize them however you like. Below the gateway, I added a 16-port switch along with two rows of network ports, half of them supporting PoE, allowing you to connect and power lots of devices. If you're trying to maximize the ports in a 10-inch rack, this is a great option, even to use with the smaller 4U rack. Now below that is a 10-gig switch. Yes, 10 gigabit. It has four 10-gigabit Ethernet ports, and the coolest part? It can be powered over PoE too. If PoE isn't an option, you can still power over USB-C, but you'll still need to uplink it to another switch, which is why I like using PoE, because it makes the most sense. The Flex 2.5 PoE is the switch that's powering the 10-gig switch, and for its size, it's pretty crazy. It has 8 2.5 gigabit ports, all capable of PoE++. It also has a combo power option, allowing it to run on PoE++, yeah, 100 watts, while using the SFP Plus for data. Very few devices can actually power this over PoE++. Outside of UniFi switches, and I'd love to see some injectors for this in the future. One unexpected challenge I ran into was that Ubiquiti put the power on the front instead of the back, unlike the original Flex. The 3D printed model I used wasn't designed for this, so I had to break out the Dremel. After almost destroying the print, I managed to make it work, and I could feed the power cable from the front to the back without damaging it too much, at least as far as I could tell. Below that is the Flex 2.5 mini switch, which, like the Flex Mini, can be powered over PoE or USB-C. Now, since it's PoE powered, it doesn't have to stay in the rack. It can go anywhere you have an Ethernet connection, like all of these PoE devices. I've uplinked it to the switch above, which provides both power and a 2.5 gigabit connection. Now, if you need extra 2.5 gigabit ports, this is one of the cheapest options. Otherwise, I still prefer the Flex Mini since I don't need 2.5 gigabit speeds on most of the devices connected to my mini switches. Now, below that is an open rack space for storage. I kind of ran out of things to install, so I figured storage might be useful, especially if you're using the 210 watt power adapter, which is pretty big. You could also keep your ISP's modem in here, or if you wanted to sneak in a mini PC for compute, I won't tell anyone. For wireless connectivity, I went with the U7 Pro, opting for a more traditional shaped model instead of the U7 Pro wall that I used in the 4U rack. Like the wall-mounted version, it's PoE powered, it has a 2.5 gigabit uplink, and supports Wi-Fi 7. It can handle up to 300 clients, and it can operate on the 6 gigahertz spectrum that's virtually unused right now. And this rack configuration doesn't stop here. Since the Cloud Gateway Max supports multiple UniFi applications, you can easily install Protect and a couple of security cameras, a doorbell camera, a PoE-powered doorbell chime, an AI key, another access point, and even another switch if you need. And here's something that's really cool. You can power the entire smaller 4U mini rack using just this one switch. First, we need to disconnect the power from the switch and the Cloud Gateway Ultra. Then we power the switch using PoE++ from the Flex 2.5 PoE. And finally, we power the UniFi Cloud Gateway Ultra using a PoE to USB splitter. And just like that, this 8U mini rack is now powering the entire 4U mini rack with just one network cable. After using these mini racks for both a home lab with compute and now a network-focused one, I can confidently say that they're more capable than I expected. When I first got the 4U rack, I thought it might be too small to be practical, but I was completely wrong. It handled everything that I needed, and if you need more space, you can even use both sides and double your density. Now, if there's one thing I can change, it would actually be the opposite of what I usually look for, and that's polish. These racks are very polished, which is great, but I can't help thinking, what if there was more of a bare-bones version? Imagine a Maker Edition that didn't have any acrylic panels, no brushed metal or extra accessories, just four posts with handles, and maybe even powder coated. Stripping it down like this could bring the cost down, making it more accessible while still allowing people to print their own panels, mounts, or accessories if they really need them. It would be like the 10-inch version of the 4-post 19-inch racks you see online, but for those who want a fully customizable, cost-effective setup. Other than cost, this is the best example of a 10-inch rack that I've seen. While I still love my 19-inch rack in my server room, this 10-inch mini rack has earned a permanent spot in my studio for testing gear. And I have to give a huge thanks to Mauricio, the talented maker behind many of the 3D printed parts in this video. Not only did he design most of what you saw in here, but he even has a fully printable 10-inch rack, and if that's too big, he even has a fully printable 6-inch version too. I'll drop links in the description to his designs, along with other awesome maker contributions I used to help make this build. If you have any questions, comments, or improvements you'd like to see in the mini rack, leave those in the comments below. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.